Oh, you made me a bubble bath. That is so sweet, boyfriend. Thank you so much.
Hi, it's me. I'm boyfriend. I am the best boyfriend to myself ever.
Well, that's why you got up here. I thought she was just exploring, but you found where the treats are. You don't want this bowl full of food. You want to scale microwaves for treats. You already got treats today. See it?
Serenity's at a motel right now so that I can go on a little adventure. But it started raining, so I came under this bridge to hang out a while until the rain stops. So I'm just putting my feet in the creek.
I really don't have much information, but I do have a couple of maps. At least you'll know where you're going. You can't get lost here. It's one road in, one road out. It's a straight shot. It's clearly marked.
Oh, if anyone could get lost there, it would be me.
Like I said, we're really not technically open, but, you know, we are allowing camping, primitive camping right now.
Fun. Okay. I'm gonna give it a go.
Okay. All right, then I guess we'll see you tomorrow.
I'm gonna give it a go and be one with nature. Me trying to go camping alone for the first time. My GPS took me on this unpaved road. I have 2 more miles of this.
Ooh, it's so pretty. I just don't want to break my car while I'm alone with no reception.
We've reached a motherfucking impasse. I definitely can't drive through that. How did my GPS even take me down this road? Dear God, after all that, I made it to where I was going.
Hello.
Hello?
I called a nice lady a few days ago about primitive camping for a night.
That's what we have right now, yes?
Yeah, can I pay for that?
Yeah, cool.
Just
pull around here, come up to the front.
Oh, okay.
All right, we have a tent. Now all I have to do is fold it back up and make it get in that shape again when I leave.
I'd crack open a cold one with the boys, but there's no boys, it's just me. So I crack a cold one with myself. It's not that cold, it's been in my car. Joe from my cat birthday party video gave me this blow up thing to sleep on, so I'm gonna try it. All right, let's test it out.
Yeah, that's comfy enough. I can sleep there. I've been sleeping in a car.
It's really cute and cozy. I think we're gonna be cozy in here. In the little side pocket, I put the bear mace that Letty gave me. I have a knife, some bug spray. I don't know, I just brought fire. I brought a torch. I'm like, I want multiple ways to like assault someone if anyone bothers me. I brought some cards in here. I want to write to people I love if I feel inspired to. I have my little book corner. Letty gave me this solar powered lantern too, so I'll use that to read by tonight. Got my little vapey pens for bedtime. The water is right out over here, so we will have some nice water noises to fall asleep to tonight. And whatever that is. Serenity is like, what are we doing now? Serenity's gonna hang out in the tent while I tackle the job of trying to make a fire for the first time. Travis gave me these before I left and he's useless.
Am I doing it?
doing it.
How come fires just start on accident all the time, but then when you want one to, it doesn't happen?
All right, attempt number three, we're gonna try burning the Jesus scripture that I got from one of my church attendances, and maybe the Lord can start a fire for me.
I know Jesus walked on water and shit. I don't know if he was starting fires. Am I going to hell for this?
Well, the leaves are working way better than Jesus did. We can't stop now.
Well, I hope I made my parents proud. I made my first fire all by myself.
I'm putting the last piece of wood on the fire. And I'm just gonna enjoy it from the tent with Seren.
Alright, we are in for the night. We're gonna read a little bit and then hopefully we'll go to bed.
Or maybe I'll still have insomnia out in the woods.
Am I tripping? Look. Are my hands magic, or is this just like some radio signal thing I don't know about?
You go chasing rabbits, and you know you're going to fall. Tell my hookah, smoking caterpillar has given you the call.
What are the odds? This is a random fucking little radio and that one of my favorite songs comes on.
So this is the inside of the little tiny house you going potty that we'll be staying in. There's a little fire so I can use it to make my little soups that I brought a ton of. The loft is up here. There's the bed. And then just, isn't this cute down here? I should have like filmed before. Now my shit is spread everywhere. And it's like not even 5 p.m. yet, and I literally want to go to sleep. I am so tired. I lugged up all of our stuff in two trips in this wagon up a giant hill, which would be a lot of work for anyone, but with my autoimmune shit, when I exert that much energy, it's like, I'm done. I'm done for the day. And I was like, oh, I have to stay awake till sunrise because I don't want to waste daylight. And then I was like, I am primitive living alone in the middle of the woods with nowhere to be. Like, why wouldn't I go to sleep now if I wanted to?
Oh my God, the stained glass is so pretty. I love this. I feel really cozy in here because it's like a structure, like I'm in a home, but I do feel primitive as fuck out here because there's no electricity or running water or nothing.
Who are you? There's a little fire pit area outside, and I'm gonna show you guys how cute this outhouse is. I saw there was an outhouse and I was like, ew. But it's actually so cute. I'm like not even mad. Check this out. It's so nice. There's a little carpet, fresh towels, a little mirror, a little broom, some candles, and you even get a window with curtains. So it doesn't feel yucky in here. It doesn't smell yucky. And then there's even a little sink pump area over here. There were some cookware stuff in here, but oh my God, look how cute. And you just use the little foot pump under here, and when you press the foot pump, then water comes out of here. So I can at least wash my hands and my face and stuff. Where's Kitty? Oh, there you are. Yeah, get some fresh air.
We just saged the place.
Yeah, get a look.
We just saged the place, so we gotta air it out. Should have good ventilation. And we got the candles going. And a little lantern.
and we're just reading some stories from the bookshelf, and it feels really, really cozy. The first book I would grab would be from Berkeley, California. That's right by where I grew up. It's called A Creative Companion, How to Free Your Creative Spirit. It's just the first thing I grabbed. And this, I'm just gonna insert this here and you can pause it and read it if you want, but this is how I feel right now. Serenity made it abundantly clear to me she wanted to go for a walk. She kept running to the door every time I opened it. I mean, she's honestly been doing that since we got here, which is so funny to me. You'd think she'd want a break from all the exploring. No, we're not going under the tiny house. But she is an explorative spirit. So we're just going on a little barefoot, bear pod walk together.
We found a book in the cabin called The Dalai Lama's Cat and the Art of Purring. So we're having a little fireplace story time tonight. The room where he spent the most of each day was silent and lighted only by the moon. I headed to my favorite spot on the windowsill. Even though the Dalai Lama was many miles away in America, I felt his presence as if he were right beside me. Perhaps it was the spell of the moonlight which cast everything in the room in an ethereal monochrome, but whatever the reason, I felt a profound sense of peace. It was the same feeling of well-being I experienced whenever I was with him. I think what he was telling me as he left on his trip was that his flow of serenity, serenity, they said your name, and benevolence is something any of us can connect with. We only need to sit quietly. We commune in the profound way possible only between cats and their human companions.
Ooh. I think thunder's coming, Seren.
Hello, gorgeous. You got a beautiful red booty.
Sometimes you just have to skip through the woods.
Sometimes you just need to hug a tree. Even the skinny trees have plenty of love to give.
Careful, hon, it gets hot. It gets hot, baby girl. It's fire.
Kitties love warm fires. How about you come in the rocking chair? There you go.
Tonight is my fifth and final night here at the cabin living primitive life. And I thought I would pull some spirit cards just to get a message, about anything relevant for me to hear right now. And the first card I pulled is the Dove card. And this reading was just going to be for me. I wasn't going to share it. But the reason this is so symbolic to me is, for one, it's numerical 21. And it's the Dove Spirit card, which wouldn't normally mean anything to me. I've never gotten this card before. But I've been reading the Bible since I've been here. My whole life, I've wanted to read the Bible front to back all the way through, because I've talked a lot of shit about the Bible in my day. And I'm like, well, it's not very fair of me to talk shit about something I haven't even read for myself. And today I was reading about the story of Noah and the Ark, and how I didn't know this part of the story. Like, I generally knew the story of Noah's Ark, but not like thoroughly. And how he would send the dove out to see if the flood had ended yet. And if there was nowhere to land, the dove would come back. But then one day the dove comes back with like fig leaves in its mouth. So clearly there's like a tree somewhere. And then one day the bird doesn't come back, because like, why would a bird come back to an ark if there was like a whole world of fig trees to be just be vibing in being a dove? So the fact that I got the dove today after I was just reading about the dove today and it really stuck out to me, and that I got number 21, which was the campsite number I chose the night before I got to this cabin when I stayed the night in a tent at Wrangley Lake State Park, just really spoke to me. And the message on the card is, be peace. And I'm gonna read the little message in the booklet.
The oracle message is, with her peaceful cooing, the gentle dove spirit invites you to embrace the energy of peace and allow compassion to warm your heart.
You always have the power to generate peace within you. And the appearance of Dove Spirit is a reminder that today and every day is a good day to meditate, to quiet any turbulence within as you embody tranquility. Above, below, and all around you. Much may be happening to distract you, but you are called to engage it with the heart of peacemaker, asking yourself, what would peace do? Can you agree to disagree? The peace you seek rises within and spreads out into the world as Spirit sends her messenger to remind you of the beauty of a harmonious existence with all that is. How beautiful and powerful is your compassionate heart. The protection message is, however disturbed the waters around you, however troubled your heart, Dove Spirit is there to remind you that peace without begins within as you reconnect with Spirit through practices that awaken you from spiritual amnesia. Your true nature is a peaceful child of Spirit, but how easily you forget. You're being invited to sit in the cozy, safe nest of Spirit. Where I am staying right now, this little cabin is called The Nest. I shit you not. And the fact that I got a bird while I'm staying in The Nest, just all the synchronicity. Soon, the waters will become still and you will feel peace again. Be compassionate with yourself at this time, for all of us can forget that peace is always at hand, always there, gifted to us by Spirit. Become the peace you wish to set in the world, and so you can reduce any suffering. Dove Spirit also reminds you that when you see inequity or someone harmed or in need, trust that you have the capacity to bring peace through smiling, sending love, speaking a kind word, and listening with a compassionate heart. Do your part to be a peacemaker, nourishing compassion, reminding others of the joy of harmonious coexistence so that they may embrace the Dove Spirit within themselves too. Also, just very interesting that it mentions like still waters and the waters becoming still when I was just reading about the Ark and the flood, and you know, floods are kind of not very still. Calm, peaceful waters and the dove. I'm just like, ooh, boom, the synchronicity is blowing my mind. From the Work Your Light deck, I picked Sisterhood of the Rose, Beauty and Devotion, Priestess, Mystic Teacher. And this one definitely describes exactly how I've spent this entire week. Sisterhood of the Rose is a lineage of priestesses, which already speaks to me because every time I pull a tarot card, I get the High Priestess. And mystics who devoted their lives to serving humanity and sending light consciousness all over the earth. A cross-section of ancient lineage, it is the path of devotion and beauty. Walking this path means being devoted to seeing and creating beauty wherever you go. The rose symbolizes the heart and the sacred geometry of all life. You are being called to notice the beauty around you, particularly in nature, and hear the whispers of Mother Earth. You are being called to spend more time in nature as all the ancient secrets live there. Mother Earth is constantly whispering. Spend time admiring her creation and you will be rewarded with insight and grace. As I've like been living off-grid in nature the past week.
You are being called to take a little more time to both notice the beauty that exists all around you and contribute to the beauty of the world in your own way too. This could be through your own creation or in the little things like how you dress to picking flowers for your home. Every time you devote your time to creating beauty, you harmonize the planet a little more and the shift in vibration can be felt. The Work Your Light action is surround yourself with beauty and create beauty wherever you go. And I do feel that, and I do aspire to create beauty wherever I go. I do enjoy styling both my flesh prison and also my home. I enjoy being in beautiful places. Like when people ask what I like to do these days, all I can say is I just like sitting or walking and or skipping or dancing in beautiful places. I enjoy taking care of my body and styling it in a beautiful aesthetic way because it not only makes me feel good, I not only have fun doing it, but I think it brightens people's day to see a sparkly, jolly lady prancing down the street. I know this seems fake as fuck. I'm like teary-eyed because it just like shook me, but the High Priestess just flew flew out of the deck. And I was just saying during my last reading with that previous card that every time I pull a card from the tarot, I get High Priestess. I don't even have to look it up because I already know what it means. So, thank you. Message received. I know I am the High Priestess.
All right, we're packing up to go. Last step is we need the kitty.
Bye, Nest. Thank you.
Birds flying high, you know how I feel. Sun in the sky, you know how I feel. Breeze drifting on by, you know how I feel. It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life for me. And I'm feeling good. Fish in the sea, you know how I feel. River running free, butterfly.